What's up, everybody? Welcome to Podcast Now. I'm Alex, and I want to talk about, in this video, Darcy Wretzky and the Smashing Pumpkins. I want to kind of analyze and talk about what the heck happened. I want to talk about what her role is to the Pumpkins, what her not being on the tour is going to mean, and how just all of this works. I find this extremely interesting. It's deeply saddening, and I want to talk about both sides of that and kind of how fans are feeling. And so let's start with that. So let's go in chronological order of what has happened here. Okay, leading up to this tour, at least in my eyes, and I think in a lot of fans' eyes, everything was looking good. Billy Corgan had said how he's talking to Darcy and that they're friends again, that they, you know, they text and all that stuff, and everything was going well. And then all of a sudden, a couple weeks before this tour announcement, which I had been following from the very beginning, all of a sudden we hear these rumors that Darcy isn't going to be doing this, and we start hearing conflicting sides. It just got really interesting, right? Darcy first, she was the first one to say it, that she was offered a role, and then she was basically pushed aside by Billy Corgan and the rest of them. And then all of a sudden the band releases a statement and says, no, well, you know, we had offered you to come and visit with us, play with us, talk to us in person, and you repeatedly said no. And then Darcy replied back and talked about her shoulder injury and kind of went into more detail. And then we got just a long text of her and Billy. And here's the thing. Do I think she's lying? She has a history of lying. They have a history of not getting along, and they have a history, especially Billy Corgan and Darcy Wretzky, but even Darcy and the band have just had this history throughout a long time of just not being on the same page and never being able to find common ground. She even talks about it, how, you know, her Billy and James would get into fights back in the day of the band, but they would get into very rarely. Like, they wouldn't yell at each other, and they only got into a handful of fights, whereas Darcy and Billy would go into screaming matches, and I believe that. In fact, we've kind of seen footage before in different documentaries of those two screaming at each other. So, you know, there is that. There is that. Is she lying? The texts seem pretty darn legit, but there's a lot to those texts, and I feel like there's definitely things missing. First thing I noticed when reading just all, I'm not going to go through all the texts, I read all the texts, but make sure you go, just type in on Google, try and find those texts. It's on like a smaller website, but they have a post of all the entire text conversation back and forth. I advise you to read it because I find it, firstly, I think it's just super interesting to watch the texts of two people that you admire or you really like and you like their music talking back and forth. But firstly, it validates a couple different things on both sides. One of the first things I noticed actually is Darcy apologized to Billy for not flying out to LA because she was with her mother and she didn't want to be rude in leaving her. That does validate Smashing Pumpkins' official statement that they had offered her to come and she had said no. So, you know, when she says all these things that he gave her an offer and then he said it wasn't an official offer, he pulled it off the table, that makes me start to think and wonder, you know, did he originally, before any of the texts she posts, say, hey, we're meeting here, or me and Jimmy are meeting here? Because in the text he did say, James isn't even here. James is doing his own thing. So it's not like he wasn't being honest at that part, right? There is a lot of honesty between both of these guys, and or guy and girl, in these text conversations. But that was the first thing I noticed, is technically she did stay behind when she could have gone. But then they, you know, they go into so much, and it is sad. It's sad to see this relationship that we've been told, both by Darcy and by Billy, that it was getting better, and we were expecting her on this tour. It was a huge, huge thing. She even put in the text, and he even put, that it would make a lot of fans very happy. It would mean a lot, all caps, to fans if she came. If she sang 2 or 7, it was a weird number, 2 or 7 songs, as long as fans are smiling, that's all that matters. He then goes on to talk about, you know, the pressure is all on them, it's not on her. And you know what, to that point, he has a point. And to their point in general, she did write, I understand. She gets it. I think Darcy gets it. She has not played bass professionally and has not even seen Billy Corgan in 19 years. She has not played an arena tour in forever. And to have her just come back you know, we don't even know what she looks like. And we kind of do, and it doesn't look very good. And that's really sad, because she was a very, very pretty girl back in the 90s, and it does show. I mean, just flat, this isn't being mean. This isn't picking on people who use drugs, but this is what drugs do to you. I mean, just plain and simple, you could see her. She was a beautiful person. She just, I mean, she's not beautiful anymore. And that's just plain. I love her. You know, she's a great musician, but that's just the truth. But no one's seen her. We don't even know if she can play bass. You know, she had kind of talked throughout the past couple years on Facebook when people would ask that. You know, I think what her, like, nephew plays the bass, and she would show him a couple things. So maybe she still plays bass, but, like, can she play the Smashing Pumpkins songs? Does she ever pick up the bass and just play? So we haven't seen her, and she's expected to go on this tour that we know is an arena tour. They're going to the Air Canada Center in Toronto, the United Center in Chicago, all these huge places. Like, you know, and she's going to be expected to go up and play an entire set with them. That's tough. That's tough. Billy Corgan knows that's tough. And I don't think he trusted her. And that's also what's sad. It seems like from the very beginning, here's what I'm getting with this, and we'll kind of wrap it up and talk about Darcy's role with the Pumpkins. It seems like Billy, from the beginning, never intended, and I have seen this in articles, and I have seen Darcy say this. It seems like from the very beginning, he never expected her to be a main touring member. Was it a mistake? Probably. Probably from a public relations and a friendship relation between Billy Corgan and Darcy Wretzky, it was a mistake for Billy to just go into it thinking she would be a special guest. He compares it to the Guns N' Roses reunion tour, where their drummer would come out and play a couple songs. It's not the same thing here. I just don't think it's the same thing here. To have Darcy come up to play two songs, would he ever play? 1979, he mentions Daydream. I assume that would have been a thing, that she would come up on stage and sing Daydream, and she did sing it on the album. Not that he couldn't sing it. I have seen him sing it multiple times, and he's really good at singing it. But, so, is that what he was planning? She'd play 1979, Tonight Tonight, maybe the huge Disarm, and then she would leave. And she would just do that a couple times on the tour. Maybe she would go everywhere with them, maybe she wouldn't. But if that is where his head was going in, That does suck. On the other side of things, I can see it. Firstly, she had the shoulder injury. And maybe he didn't trust her when she's saying that she doesn't need surgery. Maybe he thinks, oh, no, you're going to need surgery. You're probably just saying that so you can come on board with us, but then you're going to eventually need surgery, and then what the heck are we going to do with this tour? I can see that being a thing. However, I do think the drugs and the uncertainty of her played a huge role in this. He hasn't seen her. He hasn't heard her. And I think going into that, that worried him. Because as in the texts, and what I do like about the text, is it does show a very strong sign to the future. Billy Corgan wants this tour to do really good. He expects it to do good. He's putting a lot of pressure on them. And he expects to nail it. He expects it to be awesome. Because he wants to prove to them that they're on top of their game and one of the best rock bands out there. He wants to get the tour out of America. And he routinely mentions to Darcy about the future. He says the door will always be open to her if she can't handle the politics and the world right now. The door will always be open. He talks about how they need to do good now so they can build a brighter future. So he keeps talking about the future, which I do like, because I think there will be a future after the Smashing Pumpkins reunion tour. I think it'll do good. I think it'll do good. At the end of the day, I am very disheartened that Darcy's not doing it. But let's talk about that next. Not having Darcy on the tour, you gotta analyze it two different ways. Now, I've seen people on Twitter that are Billy Corgan fans, big name Twitter personalities in their own fields, and one of them was saying how, you know, Darcy not coming back on the tour, and then saying, like, well, she didn't even play on the side, like, he played all of her parts on Siamese Dream, their best album. And you know, and kind of like defending Billy Corgan in that way and saying, like, well, you know, he did all the work for her anyway throughout all of time. That's hard to say. I don't agree with that point of view, because there's two ways you can look at it, and I only look at it one way. It's not about Darcy the bass player. This is not about that. Anybody can play bass. Jack Bates is going to be playing bass. Okay? He's a pretty good bass player. He was actually with them on the Marilyn Manson tour. I saw him. He's decent. He's very quiet. He plays the bass extremely quiet, which I actually don't like. I don't think he's the best bass player in the world, but he's a bass player. And that's all they need. The Smashing Pumpkins have never been known from their basses. It's Jimmy Chamberlin on the drums, Billy's voice, and the two guitar players sounding like 1,000. That's always been the Pumpkins. It's never been about the bass. So when we talk about the music aspect of the tour, are they going to miss anything from not having Darcy? No. Anybody can play the bass. Her backing vocals are really good, but you don't need them. He's done it before without her. What you need to realize, what those people that are tweeting all that stuff need to realize is, yes, you know, Siamese Dream is basically just Billy Corgan and Jimmy Chamberlain, but like 90% Billy Corgan. Okay. But it's the presence of Darcy. They've gone without Darcy before. It, you know, she left after Adore. And then when Jimmy Chamberlain came back and they did the final Machina tour, they did the farewell tour. And it's the presence of seeing. That's, and Billy Corgan knows this. And that's why I have to believe, and I want to believe, that even though they've had disagreements, and they probably don't like each other again, and he ended their conversation talking about her face being on t-shirts, and that's pretty much it, I have to believe they're trying to work something out, or at least they're thinking about it. Because I think it'd be a stupid thing to do to let her go. She even says it. She's like, don't throw out a good thing, and you know it's not me I'm talking about. I think it's their relationship. I think it's the whole aura of them that she's talking about, not literally her. And I agree with that. Seeing her on stage would have been really cool. We've seen Jimmy Chamberlain. We saw him in Zwan. We saw him in Zeitgeist. We saw him in 2015. We saw James Iha. We've seen him before, Perfect Circle. We've seen him. We've seen him. We've seen him play solo shows where he's played Mayonnaise. And we've seen him back in 2016 when he showed up a couple times on Billy Corgan's tour. These people are people we've actually seen. Nobody has seen Darcy in a long time. Just her presence alone and seeing her would have been special. And it's gone now. And that hurts. That actually hurts. It hurts me. I think it hurts Lifetime fans. I think fans that didn't know any of this stuff leading up to it, and a lot of people I'm sure did, didn't know anything, are now looking at this reunion tour where it says Billy Corgan, James Iha, Jimmy Chamberlain, and Jeff Schroeder are going on tour. And they're like, wait, well, that's not the original four. They must have spelled Darcy's name wrong and they replaced it with Jeff Schroeder. You know what I mean? So I think those people are probably very, very sad because it's like, what? And I understand people that were saying you can't call it a reunion tour unless you have all four. In a way, I agree with that because they came back in 2007. It was just two of them. They are coming back now. Now they got three of the four. It's so close. But basically, this reunion tour is a welcome back James Iha tour. That's what this tour is. Welcome back, James. And we've seen him. No, he hasn't played in the Smashing Pump. Even when he came back with Billy Corgan, you know, a year or two ago, it was a Billy Corgan tour. It wasn't a Smashing Pumpkins tour. So they haven't played as the Smashing Pumpkins. And this is obviously, like I said in the last video, going to be like a reflecting back from between Gish and Machina. And I think that's going to be so cool. But Darcy was part of that. Yes, she didn't do the bass parts in Siamese Dream. Jimmy wasn't on Adore. And Adore is a beloved album of theirs now. That album has aged super well. Now, Darcy wasn't on Machina. She wasn't on Machina. And Machina is one of the best, I think. It's weird. Machina is a weird album, and it's very hard to put into words. But Machina 2, all those B-sides, all those songs, those are some of my favorite material from Smashing Pumpkins. They can do stuff without Darcy. They don't need her presence even in the room recording, because he's made some tremendous songs without her, even on Machina. Some fantastic songs. But we have not seen the original four since 1996. I think that's what people are forgetting. You go through the history. Jimmy Chamberlain had the drug problem. He went into rehab. They fired him. It was the three of them through Adore. Darcy left in 1999. Jimmy came back in 2000. They did Machina and they did the tour and Darcy wasn't there. So the four of them have not been on stage together since 1996. 21 years. That's when I was born, was June of 1996. That was the last time they were on stage together, all four of them. And it looks like we're still going to have to look. And that's the thing. The Pumpkins are iconic to us, right? The fans, they're iconic. And we have not yet seen them in present day all together. We're going to see three of them together. And there's nothing wrong with that. And that's going to be amazing. I'm going to the Toronto show. It's going to be a blast. I'm super excited. I'm more excited for that than a lot of things in my life. But we haven't seen them all together. And that memory, in order to see the iconic Smashing Pumpkins, you'd have to go back to their Siamese Dream tour. You'd have to go back, watch back, you know, if you type in Smashing Pumpkins 1979, the best version of 1979 is when all four of them were playing it. There's not a lot of versions of that, because soon after, Jimmy, you know, destroyed his life, and then Darcy destroyed hers right after that. So, and, you know, it's not picking on anybody either, but that's just the way it is. So we have not yet seen the four of them in 21 freaking years, and that's sad. And we, the most disappointing part is we had it. They were friends. That's what's upsetting to me. They were friends. They were talking. And something happened. There was a trust issue. There was a trust issue. Something went bad, and clearly we can see from the text they spiraled out of control. Should Darcy have done those Facebook posts and stuff to make the issue even worse? She should not have. That was her mistake. That could come back to bite her. That could make it so that she will never be on this tour. But I really hope that they see fans' reactions that are saying, where is Darcy? We want Darcy. Darcy wants Darcy to be in it. We want Darcy to be in it. We want her in the right way, though. I don't want her to come and ruin the show because she can't play anymore. And I don't want her presence also just completely taking away from everybody. It's about seeing all of them together, not just Darcy. But, you know, we've seen Billy, and we've seen James, and we've seen Jimmy. But we haven't seen the four of them, and we haven't seen Darcy just in general. So it's really disheartening. It really sucks. But again, I wanted to kind of analyze all the aspects. In terms of music influence, it's not a big deal. But in terms of just presence and seeing them and memories and emotion, it's a huge deal. And I think, I believe this tour is going to do good, like I said. I already said that like five times. Sorry for repeating. I think the tour is going to do good. But I can't help but feel that it won't do that good. I think that they're missing Darcy, and that is going to hurt them in some way. It's going to hurt them in some way. And it's just crazy because, you know, her relationship with James and stuff, and he didn't... He should have put his foot... I think... I don't know. It's hard. It's hard because he could put his foot down and say, we need Darcy. But, like, does Darcy make it better? And does Darcy fit with the Smashing Pumpkins? And can Billy get along with her? It's tough. I'd much rather them, you know, reconcile their differences and go on this reunion tour, maybe, if we all pray, have Darcy come as a special guest a couple times, show that things are getting slightly better, you know, a couple years go by, they talk about doing an album, they all get together, they do an album, or they do another tour, and Darcy is fully part of it. That's the best case scenario I see, and I really hope it happens. So, that's what I think. That was a lot. I don't even know who's watching this. I just wanted to make this video just for whoever's out there. You know, I think if you are a Smashing Pumpkins fan, I hope you've liked this video. I hope you liked the last video talking about the reunion tour. I want to make Smashing Pumpkins content. Clearly, I'm very passionate. I love the band. They're my favorite band of all time. They really, really touch me in a way that no other band can, or ever has, or ever will. And so I do want to make content for them. And we're going to start doing that very, very soon. In a couple weeks, every other week, we're going to make a Smashing Pumpkins video. So I'm very excited to do that. We'll be reviewing albums. We'll be talking about specific songs. We'll be talking about just specific aspects of the band. We can probably come back to this issue. And we can do basically whatever we want, talking, you know, leading up to the tour and stuff. So I want to do that. I need your guys' support, though. You guys need to watch it. Hopefully there is support on this. So I really appreciate it. I really appreciate anybody that's watching this. So let me know in the comments below. What do you guys think about this? Let me know. We answer all comments back. If you have any suggestions for future Smashing Pumpkins videos you want me to do, leave them in the comments below. I will 100% get to every one of them. That's just who we are as a channel. That's what we do. And we like to talk, if you didn't notice by like the runtime. It's a discussion channel. We really like to explain things and go in depth with it. And I think that helps having a knowledgeable person doing that. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you on the next Smashing Pumpkins video.